Jonathan Paula presents Game Time. Hello and welcome back to another exciting episode of Game Time Hotshots. My name is Jonathan Paula, and today and for the next six videos, we're going to be traveling into the very depths of hell itself to play Doom 3 on the computer. This first-person shooter was the highly anticipated second sequel to the Doom franchise, which, quite frankly, revolutionized first-person shooting. And one of the reasons I picked it for this particular week, the week in Los Angeles where the Electronics Entertainment Expo was going on, Doom 3 was actually the best in-show title at the 2002 E3. It's been 9 years since then, and this game is still awesome, the graphics still impress, and the game is still scary as shit. I haven't played this game since I bought it back in the fall of 2004. In fact, I still have my save files to prove it. In fact, with the exception of the first two, which are me testing controls earlier this week, I have not played this game in over 2,300 days. You can see the last save file here was December 17, 2004. So I'm not going to resume my game because I don't remember where I left off at all. Instead, we're going to start a new game, and I'm going to put the difficulty on Recruit because, quite frankly, I would like to get as far as I can in six videos rather than just dying constantly with you guys watching over my shoulder. But in any event, I'm looking forward to this. This is the first-person shooter we've done here on Game Time, so it should be exciting. I am recording this at 4 o'clock in the morning. All of the lights in this room are off, and quite frankly, I am looking forward to being scared. I remember Doom 3, when I got it back in 2004, was one of the first games I ever played on the computer I'm using now, the self-built, quote-unquote, the bitch computer with my 5.1 stereo sound. And this game, I cranked all the graphics to the max, I cranked the speakers with the 5.1, and it scared the shit out of me because you were hearing things behind you. It was insane. But let's listen to the preamble here.
Originally focused on weapon and defense contracts, new ventures have expanded into biological research, space exploration, and other scientific endeavors. With unlimited funds and the ability to engage in research outside of moral and legal obligations, the UAC controls the most advanced technology ever conceived.
Oh, so they're like Google? All right. A bit clarification on that last thing I said, though. While this is the same, quote, computer, I've upgraded it so much it's basically a new computer, but I think you get what I mean. The first computer I ever built myself was back right before I got this game. I built it in August of 2004, and I got this game in September. What is this? What is this? What's going on? Are we watching Mission to Mars with Gary Sinise here?
You're coming in too fast!
Oh, look at that.
Excellent. See that Counselor Swan is sent directly to me.
I'm telling you, seven years ago, these graphics still hold up. They are really impressive.
Dark Star on final.
They were mind-blowing back in 2004. Right? So, this is us, the unnamed space marine on the Mars.
Welcome to Mars.
See?
All new arrivals need to check.
You got it, Chief.
Welcome to Mars City. Union Aerospace's premier research facility.
I gotta get out of here.
Processing. Please proceed directly to reception.
What is all this crap?
Rain?
What? What's going on here?
I'm gonna need you to step on one of those red squares on the floor for a bio.
Sure, no problem. You gonna scan my dick?
Okay, let me get this started. Oh shit! Oh my god!
Moving around.
What did he say about moving around? He said it makes it better, right? Oh, sweet. Gotta get myself a Coke. Download.
Study and military operations.
Come on, when do I get to do the cool shit?
Welcome to Mars. First time? You can just leave your bag there. I'll have it sent up your quarters. Okay, there's a few things we need to take care of first. This is your personal data assistant. You'll need this to access all secure areas. If you get clearance for any security zones, it'll download directly. It's important, so don't lose it.
So let me get this straight.
I see here that Sergeant Kelly has requested your immediate attention.
We're using PDAs in
Head
the future?
Directly to Marine Command. It's just that way. Follow the signs.
You got it, Chief. Your PDA is critical to your work at the UAC. Toggle your PDA with the blah 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 blah. I don't give a shit. Let's just move. I got stuff
Mars
to do here.
Mars City is a smoke-free facility. Please smoke only in designated areas. Thank
what's
you
up,
for
dude?
Your
punch to the face.
I'm
you're never gonna see me again either.
There seems to be some very serious problems.
Oh, really? Do I need to remind you of the groundbreaking work that we're doing here?
What's wrong with your face?
But I've been authorized by the board to look at everything.
Did you say he's been authorized by the Borg?
Oh, jeez. The board doesn't know the first thing about science. All they want is something to make them more money, some product.
First they assimilate, now they want money?
They get their product.
The Borg just don't let up.
After how many accidents? Tell me, Dr. Petruger, why are so many workers spooked, complaining, requesting transfers off Mars?
Maybe because Mars doesn't have an atmosphere?
They're exhausted and overworked. If I had a larger, more competent staff and bigger budget, even these few accidents could have been avoided.
I bet you'd like something else to be bigger, too.
I'm afraid you'll get nothing more until my report is filed with the board. I will need full access, Dr. Petruger, Delta included. I won't have any difficulties doing that, will I?
Yes, you will.
Only if you get lost, Swan. Just stay out of my way. Amazing things will happen here soon. You just wait.
So, are his eyeballs rendered incorrectly, or is he supposed to look like a freak? Well, speaking of the Borg, my good friend Riley McElwain just launched his very own Game Time series on his channel. I helped him get set up with the graphics and stuff, and he's also doing a first-person shooter this week on his channel, Star Trek Elite Force. He's battling the Borg and all sorts of other cool aliens. And I definitely encourage you go check out his channel if you haven't already subscribed to it, because he's doing game videos now like I am, and they are really fun, because Riley's a fun guy. Okay, back to Doom.
Yeah, so those suits arrived too. I'm really trying to get this fixed quickly, so, do you mind?
I do mind. Because I need to know where I'm supposed to go. I'm supposed to talk to some chick about some stuff. When you approach an interactive computer interface, your weapon, if equipped, will lower, and you can use the fire button to interact with the computer. Downloading. Data sent to PDA. Let me in. Fuck this shit. Where do I get to shoot stuff?
Attention, Dr. Braddock. Please report to Environment Management Office.
Need report to Sergeant
Alpha.
Kelly ASAP.
Yeah, you keep telling me that. Why is this place so big?
We would like to request another security team here in Delta.
Yes, sir.
All right, what's going on in Delta? Why is everyone talking about this Delta? Hey, what's up? Whoop, just talk a video disc. Video discs are boring. Is this a puzzle game or a shooting game? Because right now I feel like I'm doing a lot of thinking, and I don't like that. Let's go. Just gotta run. Oh shoot, what's going on there? That guy doesn't look so hot. Alright.
I can't be interrupted now.
Well, maybe you shouldn't be working in a hallway, alright? Dumb shit.
Don't waste any more time. Oh.
Maybe we need to go this way. Aha! Puzzle solved.
Took your sweet time,
yes.
Marine.
I did. I got lost.
No. Here's the situation. Another member of the science team's gone missing. Since you're the ranking FNG, you get to find him.
That stands for
I want
fucking
you to check
new
out
guy.
The old decommissioned comm facility. We heard he might be heading that way. The only way there is through the service passage under Mars City. I programmed this sentry to guide you to the maintenance elevator. I hope you follow the sentry better than you've followed orders so far. You pick up some gear at the security checkpoint at the bottom of the elevator.
I thought
oh,
I followed
when you find
him,
pretty
good.
Just bring him back. Do not hurt him. Now move out.
You got it, Chief. Let's go, Robit. I'm following you. Don't wake up your Robit friend. We only want one of you guys running around here. Because quite frankly, I don't trust you. Any day now, Skynet is going to go online and you're going to turn against us. And I don't want to be here for that.
Volunteer at Delta Labs today. See your service.
I'm not going to volunteer at Delta Labs. All I've heard is bad things. And based on what I remember from when playing this game 7 years ago, Delta Labs is literally hell itself. I plan to avoid that this time around. Because there's definitely going to be a way to, like, circumvent the game's narration, right, John?
The UAC cares about the
shut up, troll.
Life of its employees. Please take advantage of our quality medical care.
I already did this whole
services.
Thing. I'm going to take that Coke can from you. Yeah, let's go. Let's go, robot. Hey, this was locked earlier. Locate maintenance entrance. Let's go, let's go, let's go. I don't have time for any of this crap. Mars City Underground, the Mars sublevel. The Mars sublevel was one of the first multi-purpose installations built on Mars. Housing, storage, environmental systems, localized energy production, communication arrays, and rudimentary research systems. The aging facility is vital to keeping Mars City operational. That worries me just a little bit. So much for first-person shooter. We're almost done with the first video here, and I haven't even shot
Welcome
a gun
to
yet.
The dungeon, Marine. Most unexciting place on Mars.
Really? Because it looks pretty awesome. There's a lot of cool shit. Well, where do I do that?
Okay, is it here? Grab your gear.
Oh, yes. Combat.
Let me do a radio test. Reload. MarsSec radio check. Excellent. Good signal. Looks like you've been assigned the decommissioned comm facility. Just follow the main passage through the underground junction, then straight out. We'll have a quick evac. And what better way to see the Martian surface than to run across it? Okay, you're all set.
Good. Thanks for opening the door.
Keep in mind, the civilians are working down here. Don't get excited and shoot any.
What if I want to shoot him? What if I don't like him? Alright, let's go here. Let's move. We're moving. Moving.
Hey. You're looking for the scientist, right?
I don't know, maybe.
I'm not sure you want to find him.
That's cool, I want to. See you later. Bye.
Listen.
When does the exciting crap happen? I want to shoot at least one alien in this first video. I feel like I failed you if I don't. What? Ah, jeez. Fuck this shit. Opening PDA. Accessing information. Grant Baston.
This is Grant Baston, the Environmental Services Supervisor.
I don't give a shit. Uh, 531. Okay, thanks. 531. Excellent. Good work. Crack the code. Game is slightly confusing. I haven't been this way yet.
Can you maintenance guys not keep any of these machines running?
Yes, sir. Just that the science team demands a lot.
Where am I supposed to go? Jeez. I think I have this flashlight here. Don't bother to light anything on Mars. It's not like we need to see where we're going or anything. What's up, Chief?
You're that new guy headed for the old comm center, right?
Yeah, probably.
Better hustle up, pal. You'll have a quick walk outside.
What? Oh, this sucks. I gotta walk outside? Jeez, come on. Why on earth would they do this? Just build a fucking tent. Cycle the airlock! Cycle the airlock! I'm dying! Probably put my flashlight away, though. Alright, I'm on the other side of the airlock. I still have not got a chance to shoot any aliens yet.
Kelly, you need to double time it down there. Search your assigned area and haul your ass back to Mars City. Out.
Alright, we still have not got a chance to shoot any bad guys, but at least we've made it to the other side of the airlock, wherever the heck we're supposed to be. So I guess that's as good a place as any to end it for today's video of Game Time. Thank you for watching, and thank you for listening. I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.